Hey everyone, so this is the next video in the series about wire mock tutorial. So this video I'm going to talk about timeout and delay. Last video was about the fault simulation, means normal error like internal server error or any resources access exception that our third party service can throw. This one is about timeout and delay. Sometimes when you are calling a third party service, there can be a delay which is not expected, and that can be introduced by the network delay, internet connection. That reason can be anything. So how we can mock those scenarios, those real time scenario about timeout and delay, how we can mock that with the wire mock, that I'm going to explain in this video, right? So this is our sample project. You are very much aware about this one. This is our service which is for which we are writing the test, and this is the third party API which our service is contacting, and the timeout part we are going to introduce at this point, right? So that our gateway can decide what to do about that timeout. Normally there is a timeout exception. There is fixed time that your service expects, that 1000 milliseconds it is going to wait, otherwise it is going to throw a timeout exception, right? So let me go to the project and show you how you can do it. So this is our ticket booking service application, and these are the different scenarios about this error, proxy, recording, stubbing that we have done, right? So to show you the demo, we are just going to reference the existing test that we have written. So this is the service request stubbing, normal one. I'm just going to copy it and pasting it and putting it in a new package, that is timeout, so that things are properly separated. So timeout it, and here we have it. And timeouts, just close other. All right, so let me explain you this. So what it is doing, so wire mock setup, it is happening here under this one. Test case one, it is the stubbing part, normal stubbing part, it is happening here. Here it is doing the preparing the request. Here it is preparing the request, and here it is calling the pay for booking, passing that request. When it is going here, so it is checking for the fraud. If it is there, it is going to call that one, otherwise directly it is going to call the make payment. When it is calling the make payment, it is from here it is calling the third party, that is pay money API, in this endpoint, that is payments. And at this payments points, rest template dot post for object, when it is calling, so we want timeout. We want timeout simulation at this point when response dot rest template dot post for object is called. So there is time, there is a delay in response coming to this point, right? So we have to configure the rest template, we have to configure the timeout at rest template, and we have to decide what to do that. So if I show you the rest template configuration here, so this is the configuration for that. For now, there is no timeout configuration, so that by default timeout that is with the rest template is going to take care of that one. But I want to simulate, but I want to add my own timeout. So how I can do that? So I have to further customize this rest template. So let me write the code for that. So for that, STP client factory. So when you write the shortcut of this one, you will get this HTTP components client HTTP request factory, right? So here factory, and here I can create the object of this one, and in this factory I can set the timeout, set connection timeout 1000. So how much time by default it is taking connection timeout, it is taking in millisecond, right? So how much time maximum time it can take to establish the connection, right? And second thing is about factory dot set read timeout. In reading the response from the third party, it is preparing the response and sending back to the back to caller service, right? So, and I want the same timeout for this as well. There is one more timeout, factory dot timeout connection timeout, connection request timeout. So that's not needed here. We are good with this connection timeout and read timeout only, right? Now set this one, set request factory. So factory, so this one is going to be set in the this rest template, right? So by doing this code, timeout is configured with the service. So now the coming to the stubbing part, right? So coming to the stubbing part, so before doing anything, if I run this one, so it should execute properly because there is no exception, there is normal stubbing going on here, right? And timeout we have configured, that is pretty much, and by default it should, there is, I should get the response without any issue in that time, right? So it should pass. So let me, it's that pass scenario. Yeah, it is passing now, right? So that's pretty obvious, right? So we have explained it in the previous video. So this is the stubbing part, and in this one I have to, the build return what it is configuring here, it is have to configure the timeout. So here you will see how easy it is to configure the timeout. So just write, not this one, okay, JSON part dot fixed delay. There is this method, right? With fixed delay, how much delay I need for the response, right? So what we have configured here, payment processor gateway, payment processor REST template here, 1000 milliseconds. So if I get the response in this time, it is okay. Otherwise, it is not okay. So let me put here 1100. So it is going to give me response in 1100 millisecond. By default, it is taking millisecond, right? So let's execute this again. So my expectation is that it is not going to give me the response in 1000 millisecond. So I should get the timeout exception, right? So let's see what happens. Yeah, it is failing. As expected, it is failing. So resource access exception, read timeout. So this exception came here. So we knew it, right? So I have to change, do the changes to this code to assert the timeout exception, right? That is happening here. So here is the assertion part, and in the last video I have explained you how you can write the what exception it is throwing and how to write the test for the exception, right? And here I have to mention the what type of exception it is throwing, exception dot class, and second argument is the a lambda expression, which is what it is the actual call to the service from which we are getting the exception, right? So just comment this out, that is not needed. Just remove it, make it clean. So here it is. So assertion also remove it and do the static imported. So yeah, so verify part and all those things are going to be the same because our service, our mock, our service is actually hitting the third party service, so that verification part also we are doing. The point is here that it is throwing an exception, so that assertion is here, right? So if I hit this again, it should pass now. So this is how easily I can introduce the timeout and delay, timeout or delay, anything you say. Yeah, it is working now, right? So it is, so this is it, how you can introduce the delay. So this is the delay about the fixed delay, right? Fixed delay of this one, but in real time scenarios, you can, sometimes you're processing a batch, right? You want to do the retry thing that, so you want the, you want to, we want to simulate the random time delay, right? So some, for some requests, it is 1000 milliseconds, for some time, for some, it is 500 milliseconds. So how we can do that? So this one with WireMock we can do that easily. So there are different flavor of this one. So if I take you to the this method with fixed delay, here we have different methods to pass the fixed delay. So here we have with random delay where I have to pass a delay distribution and it is going to take care of that. So how to pass the implementation of this one, I will tell you in a while. Coming to the next one, with long normal random delay, right? So it is going to, here it is creating this one. So when you are using this one, you just have to pass two things, median milliseconds and the sigma part, right? And then if you want to see the explanation about this one, you can come here, 50th percentile of the distribution in millisecond, and the second one is the standard deviation that you want for the distribution part. Coming to the next ones, with uniform random delay, it is going to take the lower millisecond value and upper millisecond value. It means you want the delay to vary between some lower limit and upper limit, then I can use this one. And I have to just pass the lower value and upper value. And as many times as I call that one, so the timeout will vary between these two values, right? If you want to more detail, you can just go to uniform distribution delay here and get the more detail here, right? So in the class, it is properly documented. And with other one is the bit chunk dribble delay. So when in my software development career, I haven't get the chance to use this one. So these are all the flavors that you can use with that you can use to introduce the timeout. And coming to the random distribution here. Here I was telling you about that how to implement this delay distribution interface, right? So you can make use of the existing interface that is there. So uniform distribution is there, which is implementing the delay distribution. So you can customize your distribution as per your need by passing different arguments and by implementing this sample milis, right? So here it is just using this one thread local random. And next lower and upper plus one is varying between those one, right? So this is how you can customize this delay distribution interface, right? So this is about it. So with fixed delay, and if I if you want to use this here, so if I write here delay, only delay, so all the things I'm getting here. So with uniform random delay, it's saying lower millisecond, upper millisecond, just pass that. With random delay, you have to implement the delay distribution interface. It is the next one, long normal random delay. You can use that one as well, right? So I'm just leaving it as it is. If you want to practice it, go ahead and try it and see it is fitting, it is suitable for your use case or not, right? So this is it about the timeout and delay. So before leaving, let me show you the WireMock documentation for this as well. So here it is the simulating faults about the documentation from official website. You can get directly here. So here it is with fixed delay. I have explained you about it. So it is the same in JSON format. If you are using a standalone server, this is the JSON file that in the JSON file, you just put this one. It is going to take care of that. Global fixed steps. This is how it is going to happen. Please the random delays and all other details about here is coming here, right? So chunk dribble delay, it has been explained here, so you can go ahead and check out this one. Bad response, these faults we have seen in the previous video, right? So this is it about this video I wanted to explain. So this is the playlist that you can go ahead and check out it, and these are the this is the GitHub page where all the source code is coming with So we covered this timeout and delay distribution as well. So next topic is about stateful behavior of WireMock. So what is the use case and how we can make use of this one? I'll explain that in the next video, right? So till then, you play around with this one. I'll see you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.